Hello, everybody. Welcome back. I am here with Mr. George Gruen at Gruen's Guitars. How are you?
Doing good today.
Great. Well, thank you for having us. And I have one question for you. You ready? Okay.
Indeed.
I'll take that as a yes. And I wrote my question down. I always like to make sure I get the questions right. So, you have a ton of experience buying guitars, evaluating guitars, and understanding the guitar market clearly. So my question is, there's an upswing in low-priced guitars. What does the manufacturer need to do to get a guitar at that low price point, and what's missing at the price point? And finally, are guitar players being cheated by buying one of these low-priced guitars?
For one thing, I don't follow the really low-end guitar market, especially. What I have experience with is high-end quality new instruments, as well as high quality used and vintage instruments. Mm-hmm. There is no question that there have been big surges of sales over a period of years on low end instruments, which can sometimes seem to be cyclical. Mm-hmm. Right now, sales are pretty good. The economy is relatively strong, but there's a huge demographic shift going on. The baby boomers are not the buyers anymore, especially on the really low-end instruments, because by the time somebody is baby boom age, they're now well past middle age. Mm-hmm. If they didn't want a guitar before, they probably don't want one now. If they didn't buy one before, they probably didn't want it then. Mm-hmm. And still don't. So we're dealing with a younger generation, many of whom really don't have as high a standard of living as the baby boomers did. Today, a lot of families have husband and wife both working, sometimes working two jobs each. Mm-hmm. And people are living in smaller apartments, smaller houses. They don't have as much physical space, and many of the millennials don't really seem to care to have huge accumulations of physical stuff.
Right.
They move frequently. They shift jobs frequently. But they can buy a student model guitar today, inflation adjusted, for far less than when I was starting out. In the 1960s, companies like Harmony and Kay and Dan Electro dominated the market for student model guitars. Japanese guitars were not a major factor in the market in the early and mid 60s. They were becoming so by the late 60s, but it was really in the early 70s that the Japanese onslaught of student model guitars started to displace major companies like Martin, like Kay and Harmony. Martin wasn't really much affected, because Martin being high-end. Gibson wasn't much affected. Fender wasn't that much affected. But Dan Electro went out of business. Kay and Harmony also folded. Those names still exist, but they're not the same company.
Right.
They're the names being resurrected under new ownership years after the original companies folded. Mm-hmm. But I also clearly remember that the early student model Harmony and Kay guitars of the early and mid 60s were really, frankly, terrible instruments. The bodies weren't too bad, but the electronics, if it was an electric guitar, were poor. And the necks were uncomfortable. The fretwork was bad. The truss rods in the necks didn't work, if they even had one at all. But the ones that did have adjustable necks, the rods were largely a placebo. It can say steel-reinforced rod, but if you actually turned the screw, nothing happened,
right.
At least nothing good. And the neck set angles were poor, and the dovetail joints for fastening a neck were not good, so that things shifted and they became unplayable pretty quickly. And a lot of those guitars are gone and hard to find now, and it's because it would have cost more money to repair them than to buy a new one, so people just threw them away.
Mm-hmm.
So there's not that many of them left. Today, for under $300, you can get some guitars that are remarkably playable, both acoustic and electric. But what does it take to do that? One, they're not made in the USA. They're made in no longer in Japan either, because today, real estate in Japan, fuel, labor, all cost as much or more than here. Actually, land costs much more in Japan. Mm-hmm. Fuel costs three times as much. Raw materials all are imported to Japan. There's no lumber to be cut in Japan. What few forests they have are national treasures. They'll cut somebody else's forests, but not their own. So that is a factor. But today you can get guitars from China, from Vietnam, from Indonesia, that are surprisingly good. Mm-hmm. The quality has vastly improved, partly because of technology. Computer numeric control equipment can cut very accurate dovetail joints and just can cut things to within a few thousandths of an inch. And if you have a good program, it's just as easy with a numeric controlled routing system to cut things with good dimensions as it is to cut them with mediocre dimensions. When the Harmony and K guitars were made in the 60s, handwork was pretty much what they had. It might be power equipment, but it was still hand-guided, and it was required much more skill to make something with a really good profile neck than to make one with a mediocre one. So the student models didn't feel, or they not only didn't sound as good as the pro models, but they didn't feel good. They didn't play well. And often enough, even the fret scale wasn't as accurate. But today, with the computer numeric controlled equipment, these things can be remarkably accurate. They don't have as good materials, and the electronic components may not be the same quality. In fact, they not only may not, they aren't. If you're buying a $250 or $300 guitar, you're not getting the same quality pickups as if you buy some of the high-end models made in the US. Mm-hmm. But you're still getting pretty good. The quality of the pickups made in Indonesia and the guitars made there, they're doing blasting down the street, is surprisingly good. So what are you getting? You're getting actually more bang for the buck on a student model guitar now than you would have 50 or 60 years ago. What are you sacrificing? Mm-hmm. Well, compared to the ones of the 50 or 60 years ago, you're sacrificing nothing. They're a better student model guitar than you could have gotten then, and they don't and inflation adjusted, they actually cost less. So that's good. If you're getting an Indonesian guitar, you're getting something as good as a custom shop Martin or Gibson or custom shop Fender. Absolutely not. But you're getting the darn good bang for the buck. So when you ask what are you sacrificing, I guess the answer is nothing. Mm. Right now, of course, with the political situation between the US and China, costs of Chinese merchandise is going up, and actually with this Chinese economy in which people are getting paid a living wage, such that some people actually have a much, much better standard of living than they ever used to over there, the cost of Chinese merchandise is rising rapidly because of tariffs, but also because of the fact that they're being paid better, and because in China there's manufacturing going on with electronics, such as, you know, Apple. Other companies are hiring workers in China, in Chinese factories where things like iPhones are assembled. And if you have a choice of working in a factory with lots of sawdust and finish fumes, mm-hmm. and sharp blades whirling around, or else in a nice, clean, quiet computer assembly place that pays more, where would you work?
Right.
So that also means that to keep people in the factories in any industry in China, they got to pay them more. So a number of factors there combined to make Chinese stuff no longer cheaper than Indonesian. In fact, in many cases now, Indonesian is cheaper. But the quality out of China, Indonesia, and Vietnam is all greatly improved over what it used to be. Mm-hmm. And if you're looking at a price point of under $400, what you're going to find is that everything available is import.
Right.
But the quality, inflation adjusted within that, is actually some of the best that it's ever been.
Wow.
It's the best in my lifetime. So it's not all bad. If you want a guitar and you want to learn, you can do it on an instrument that has accurate intonation, a comfortable contoured neck, looks pretty good, feels pretty good, and actually sounds better than those Harmony and K guitars of the mid and early 60s.
I think you just made a lot of people really happy by, you know, validating, because we get comments all the time, people saying all the time that, you know, it's the disposable income isn't, like you said, it's just different today than it used to be. And a lot of people looking for, you know, to pick up an instrument in that price point. So I think you made a lot of people happy by validating that. So thank you for sharing your insight with us. And I appreciate it very much.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you.
My pleasure as usual.